let's hear a great big amen, okay? You know, this old ship's been through some battles before. It's been through storms and tempests and rocks on the shore. Though the hull may be battered, don't worry about it. Inside, it's safe and dry, and my friend, it will carry its cargo to the port in the sky.
God has always had a people. Many a foolish conqueror has made the mistake of thinking that because he had driven the Church of Jesus Christ out of sight, that he had stilled its voice and snuffed out its life. But God has always had a people. The powerful current of a rushing river is not diminished because it is forced to flow underground. No, the purest water is a stream that bursts crystal clear into the sunlight after it has forced its way through solid rock. There have been charlatans who, like Simon the magician, sought to barter on the open market that power which cannot be bought or sold. But God has always had a people, men who could not be bought, and women who are beyond purchase. Yes, God has always had a people. There have been times of affluence and prosperity when the church's message has been nearly diluted into oblivion by those who sought to make it socially attractive, neatly organized, and financially profitable. It's been gold-plated, draped in purple, and encrusted with jewels. It's been misrepresented, ridiculed, lauded, and scorned. These followers of Jesus Christ have been, according to the whim of the times, elevated as sacred leaders and martyred as heretics. Yet through it all, there marches on this powerful army of the meek, God's chosen people, who cannot be bought, flattered, murdered, or stilled. On through the ages they march, this church, God's church triumphant, alive and well. Rejoice!
For we settle the question. We've made our choice. And the end of free now. Songs of victory swell. For the church triumphant is alive.
Listen, child of God, it's alive. The scourged pastor is healing.